Hey girl, what's up? It's your girl tonight, Monique, and I am back with another video. In today's video, I am giving you guys my after shower skincare routine for the fall. So if you are interested in how I get myself ready for bed, make sure you guys stay tuned. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and let's get right into the video. Shower routine linked on this side or this side, so make sure you guys check that video out after you have watched this one in case you missed it. My in shower routine has not changed much. I'm still using a lot of Dove products. I have really sensitive skin, so I either have to use the Dove sensitive skin or the white. Nothing has changed with that. As soon as I get out of the shower, the first thing that I do is, of course, dry my skin off. I try to make sure that my skin is kind of damp. And I put on my Dove deodorant. I love Dove's deodorant because it is like easy to put on. This one is the Advanced Care. And you don't have to worry about the white marks getting all over your clothes or anything like that. After putting on deodorant, because it is the fall time, a lot of times in the summer months, I really do not sleep in lotion or oils, but I have been using my Dr. Teal's oil. This oil is so soft, it's lavender, so it's really soothing. It's an essential oil. It's not only a body oil, but it's also a bath oil. So if you're into baths, which I don't want to say I'm not into baths, I just haven't thought about taking a bath. When I was into taking baths, I would drop a little bit of this in my water. Lately, I have really been into showers because my lifestyle is very quick, on the go. This is the Dr. Teal's lavender. It's full of moisture, smells so good, so soothing, and it just gives your skin like a glow. I always try to put some type of oil or lotion on my body after getting out of the shower to lock in the moisture. I want my skin to be as soft as it possibly can be, and I feel like the best way to do that is to lotion as soon as you get out of the shower. So put on my deodorant, and then I put on my oil, and we're good to go, fully moisturized. The next thing that is included in my shower aftercare routine is my Crest whitening strips. I try not to use these every single day. I use these maybe about once or twice a week. These 3D whitening strips are very good for your teeth. I love for my teeth to be white, shiny. I get a lot of compliments about how I keep my teeth white and clean. Well, one thing I use is this. Secondly, I brush my teeth 2 to 3 times a day, depending on what I'm doing and where I'm going. And finally, I always go to the dentist. So make sure y'all are keeping up on your dentist appointments and getting your teeth cleaned regularly. The next thing that I do is a little bit of skincare. Lately, I have been using this Clean and Clear Aloe Vera Acne Prone Gel Moisturizer. This is really good. I not only put this on my face, but I have a really bad burn on my arm in which I put it on as well. It is so soothing, it calms the pain. The moisturizer is not overbearing to a point where it locks in oil and your skin creates oil. This is not that type of ordeal. In fact, it actually says oil free plus sensitive, so this is a really good product. And the last and final product that I use in my aftercare nighttime routine is this Wet n Wild lip scrub. This is the watermelon flavor. Granted, I do not like watermelon. I actually do not even like this, but when I say this lip scrub leaves my lips feeling so soft and moist, that's just what it is. Like, you have to get you a scrub. If you don't get you a lip scrub, you can easily go to the kitchen and mix up your sugar and essential oil and create your own lip scrub at home, which is pretty cool and unique. But this lip scrub by Wet n Wild is super amazing. It gets all the dead skin off of my lips, and it does not leave my lips feeling greasy like I have lip gloss on all day. So it definitely does the trick. And I feel like in the fall time, winter time, we also need a lip scrub in our routine because our lips can be chapped. That can be chapped any season, but the brutal cold months are very important for making sure you take care of your lips. And that is it for today's video. I hope you even try some of these products. If you do, definitely let me know in the comments how you like them, how they're making out. Let me know what y'all think if y'all decide to try out any of these good products. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.